Alrighty guys, welcome back to some more Sly 3 Honor Among Thieves. When we left off last time, we had just finished up episode 4, A Cold Alliance. We did the heist, and we got rid of General Sal. Carmelita took care of him for us, but anyways, I guess you could say that she fried that chicken, if you know what I mean. Anyways, we are going to move on to episode 5, Dead Men Tell No Tales. Alrighty guys, this is... Well, I kind of consider this the last episode in the game, let's get right into it. Let's start it up and see what we need to do.
We got the message late one Saturday night. Dimitri was calling in the favor I promised him back in Holland. He got ahead and booked the whole team passage under assumed identities. To none other than Bloodbath Bay. Easily the most lawless town on Earth. It's home to a group of cultural hermits who doggedly maintain the ways of their pirate forefathers. The cruise over gave us some time to get the rundown from Dimitri. I guess his grandfather, Remy Lousteau, was a pioneer in deep sea diving. He'd made a fortune looting undersea wrecks. Although, his luck ran short when a young cutthroat by the name of Black Spot Pete stole not only his loot, but his precious diving gear as well. A broken man, Remy retired from treasure hunting and eventually started a family. Dimitri, growing up on his grandfather's stories, dreamed of one day recovering the gear. So that was our task. We've been called in to get our hands on this miraculous diving equipment. Not all bad, really. If things go our way, the team might get a frogman out of the deal, which Bentley figures will be a big help cracking the Cooper vault. That Bentley, always thinking.
Yeah, Sly's looking like a gangster. Sly Cooper and the gang in... Dead Men Tell No Tales. Alrighty, episode 5. Let's get this started. Now, I was saying how this is the last episode in the game. It is considered the last episode in the game, but there is, you know, there is more story after you know, Dead Men Tell No Tales. Anyways, we are here. Murray, wake up. Stop sleeping. Let's check the thief net, see if we've gotten any more. I'm sure we have. We've got the reduction bomb. I can't tell what's new for Murray. I don't think anything is new for, well, actually, there's jump attack. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and buy push attack level 2. I think I was saying how I was going to do that at the end of episode 4. Anyways, we're going to turn into Sly and head out and do the first mission, Bloodbath Bay, the Caribbean Sea, and I couldn't see early in the morning. Alrighty, so there is the first mission, the Talk of Pirates. And, you know, I kind of like episode 5. I like the area. Look at that shark right there. He's a dead shark. And so it looks like the animals or the guards, that is a big dog, is the flashlight guard. And, there's like a chihuahua, I guess, is one of the other guards. And... I think the last guard is just a smaller type of dog, I think. Yeah, they kind of ran out of ideas. Basically, all of the I think they're all some sort of dog. You know what I mean? Because, you know, pirates, you're like, oh, you scurvy dog, and all that stuff. So, I guess that's why they use dogs. I never really had thought of that before. We're going to make our way over here to the first mission, which I guess you could consider a recon mission, if I remember it. We're not exactly doing recon, I don't believe.
There he is, Black Spot Pete.
I didn't think pirates could get that old. Thought scurvy would get him or something.
Don't lower your guard for an instant. All pirates are killers, plain as that. And they don't trust outsiders at all. How's your pirate accent?
Arr, I forgot me number 2 pencil for the Scantron test.
Joke all you want, but that guy won't help us out until you've earned his trust.
Are there even Scantron tests in Sly's world? Man, he must have a pretty pretty bad world if there's Scantron tests. We all know what that is. Yeah, see, here's the other type of guard. He's just another type of dog. Let's take him out. And then we've got to go talk to, actually, we have to put our disguise on, don't we? We're supposed to have a pirate disguise. Let's try this out.
Black Spot Pete, I've come to talk of treasure, a subject I hear you're familiar with.
Treasure! But I will chatter with the likes of you, so blessed a subject. Get out of my sight, landlubber! All my years I only spoke of the golden kindness with me partner, cantankerous stem.
Maybe we can work out a bargain.
Shut your mouth, whore lover, and cork it with me cutlass. Hard on the tonsils, I assure you.
Dang. He's gonna stuff my mouth full of sword, apparently. That's what he was just saying.
Salt of the earth, that black spot, Pete.
It's clear to get anywhere with the old coot. We'll need to fool him into thinking that you're cantankerous Tim.
What happened to Tim, anyway?
His lieutenants mutinied on the old guy and divided the plunder, including his captain's outfit.
This is the only real pirate town left. They must be around here somewhere.
You're right. That's Stone Jake. Toughest guy you'll ever meet. He took the eye patch.
Tough enough to take an anchor dropped on his head?
Good plan. That'll do the job, matey. Stone Jake has
Alrighty.
A thing about monkeys. If you whack the palm trees, he's sure to come running. Perfect for luring him under the anchor.
What? Be that monkey?
Yeah, he like freaks out when you hit trees, apparently, because he thinks they're monkeys, and he doesn't like monkeys too much. Where's he going? Come down here.
Run with your opposable palms.
Is he going to run all the way around, I guess? We have to lure him over to the... Oh, he's coming this way.
I'll find you.
Hopefully he didn't just see me. I think he did. Yeah, he's shooting a cannon at me, so I think he did see me. You know, I guess this is one way to lead him over here. Oh, he's leaving. Come back. Come back, Stone Jake. Here he comes. Yeah, there's a monkey over here. Come over here. Oh! He just disappeared, and he said tricky monkey after he was dead, so we got the eye patch as it flies over into our hand from, like, 20 feet away. Alrighty, so I guess we have to just go around stealing the outfit for Cantankerous Tim in order to talk to Black Spot Pete. I guess he's blind enough to not notice his friend, like, to notice that we're not his best friend, but oh well. Can't make it up there. I know, I almost just got seen. Yeah, I just did get seen. These guys have cannons, too, so not the best idea to try to mess with them. Where am I going here? Up there? Gotta steal something else, from the outfit.
Peg leg? Seriously? Isn't that kind of... harsh?
You'll need it for the costume. It's very unique. Look, what you need to worry about is getting past his bodyguards.
I'll have to pick them off one by one. Shouldn't be a problem.
Alrighty, so this kind of reminds me of from Sly 2 Band of Thieves when we had to follow the Contessa in, like, episode 4 or 5. And we had to deal with two of her guards, and we had to use sound to lure them away, because if you just try to take on two flashlight guards, well, basically, good luck with that. So, I'm gonna try to do that. Now they're both coming over here. Maybe that'll... Okay, so is he. I guess I have... Well, can I drop this on their head, maybe? No? Maybe I can... I have to, like, you know, make a sound far enough away that they will separate from him, but he'll keep walking on because he didn't hear it. I mean, I do have the silent obliteration, but it doesn't work at super close. Like, I think they'll still be able to hear me, possibly. If he would keep walking, this would be a lot easier. Go on. Keep walking. Alright, hopefully he won't hear this. Okay, only he heard it. Very good. That's what I wanted. Now I have to figure out how to get around him, though. Here, come over. Come over here. No. Okay, maybe since he's far enough away, I can take him out now. Yeah, see, the other guy didn't even notice. Alright, that's... Alright, we're doing good. Hey, look over... Look over here. Oh, can I not break these? I guess not. Can't break those. Can break this this fish stall over here, though. So as soon as they keep on moving, I have to wait for the guy in front, the lieutenant, to get far enough away. What is he doing? He's just sitting down? Okay, I guess he takes little breaks like that. All right, come over here. All right, the guy didn't hear it. Let's... Oh, wait, I can actually go around over here. It seems like it's the middle of the day, but I guess they need flashlights to see. It said it was like 7 a.m. or something. I mean, it seems light enough outside that they don't need, you know, flashlights, but... Oh, well. And we just take the peg leg out from under him. And I guess that killed him. Okay.
I'm afraid word's gotten out that someone is taking down lieutenants, and he's hiding out up in a crow's nest.
He's up in a crow's nest? Okay, so we have to find a way up there, which is probably... Actually, he's way up there on the top of the ship. That guy is paranoid. Alrighty, so let's fly ourselves over there. And we can, you know, climb up there and take him out. Somehow, okay, I was about to say, how did I not get seen? Because that guy jumped up right next to me. I think they're gonna leave me alone, though, because I'm too far away now.